गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग
सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग। सो एंड इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी वर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द नेचर ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स, सिंबोलिज्म, लैंग्वेज ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स। दीज टू थिंग्स वी हैव डिस्कस्ड इन द प्रीवियस क्लास and side by side we have also seen that why it is necessary to study nature of mathematics in order to be a effective mathematics teacher, means why it is required to study the nature of mathematics in general, in particular, and in general why we study the nature of a discipline, nature of a subject, even the nature of the content when we think of the effective engagement of a learner in the learning situation that we have seen till now. And in the next part of the nature of mathematics, today we will discuss some other nature like abstractness, like precision and accuracy, and so on we will discuss one by one. One of the nature of mathematics is the it is a abstract in nature. Likewise, the content from the other discipline, they are easy to feel, they are easy to observe, they are easy to visualize, even they are easy to illustrate. Suppose that, and some of the example I have mentioned in the previous class also, that the examples or the phenomena, better to say that the phenomena or the mathematical concept in the physical science, in the chemical science, in the biological science, or even from the social science, we can observe in and around us, we can demonstrate, we can feel like that. The one of the concept and the phenomena from the physical science is the gravitation. We can feel the gravitation. Okay, we can demonstrate the effect of a gravitation also. Like a chemical science, we can also demonstrate the different chemical reactions. We can observe the reaction. We can see the product. We can see the what were the reactants and what is the final product. Like that, when we see the concept from the social science and humanities, we can also see, we can demonstrate like that the democracy that we study in the social science, we can demonstrate. And that's why we have in school school parliament, children's parliament, and through that we can demonstrate and make the learner easy to understand. But in contrary to that, in mathematics there is a certain limitation, like that the mathematical concept is very difficult to demonstrate, it is not easy to observe. Like that example I was giving, the number, it is a difficult to show the number rather than we show the quantity. And I was showing you in the previous class example of a pen. Suppose that this is the three pen. We can show the three objects, but we cannot show the three numbers. We can show the four finger, but we cannot show the four. We can symbolically represent the point, plane, line, line segment, rays, but in fact exact point, line, line segment, rays or a plane is difficult to plot, because the definition of a point says that it is a dimensionless, but it will be never possible to plot such a point which is really a dimensionless, which doesn't have a thickness, which doesn't have a breadth, length, kind of a thing. So it's difficult, and that's why while teaching a mathematics, it requires an extra effort to illustrate them with simulation, because exact we cannot show. So there are a lot of variety of examples are required to teach a mathematics. A lot of teaching aid is required to teach a mathematics. A lot of explanation is required to teach mathematics. And that's why mathematics, the nature of mathematics is different from the other. It is more abstract in nature than the other discipline. I'm not saying that the concept of the other discipline is not abstract, but they are not as abstract as the mathematical concepts are. Okay, so it is the one of the nature which says that we have to use a lot of explanation, lot of teaching aid to illustrate the mathematical concept, to show the mathematical concept, unless or until the teaching learning process of a mathematics will not be in the full manner, it will be hampered. When we go towards the other thing, suppose that in mathematics, if we add two number, it is 4.5 and 3.3, 4.5 and 3.3, it will be 7.8. It will be exact, means when you will add a two number, when you will sum up or when you will divide, when you will multiply, when you will subtract, we will get an exact number. There is no point of if and but that what will be the result. Result will be same whether you are adding in the department or whether you are going to home and adding, whether you are adding at in America or whether you are adding in a Delhi, the result will be same. But it is not true for the physical concepts. Suppose that the acceleration due to gravity, it is dependent upon the position where you are calculating it, because it is a dependent upon the location from the center of Earth. Okay, so that's why in that sense other discipline may not be exact, whereas the mathematics is the exact science. When I say this, some of my student ask a question, sir, when we solve the quadratic equation, we get two result. So where is the exactness, where is the uniqueness in the result? Please remember, in that case also the results are exact and it is a unique, because you will not get another set of a number that will solve that quadratic equation. Means it is the set of number which is unique and exact. You won't get, suppose that we have a quadratic equation and we are getting a solution like 5 and 3. So the set of number 5 and 3, it will be always exact and accurate and unique. You won't get another set of a number as a solution for that quadratic equation. So in that sense it is a exact and accurate, and that's why when you must have remembered that when I was teaching in the last semester about the constructing items for a questionnaire, and that time I have told you that when we frame MCQ in mathematics, then the distractors like none of these and all of the above is not valid, especially in the case of mathematics, because mathematics is an exact science and it will have a unique solution. So the cases of like all of these all of the above or none of this is not valid at all. You may raise a question that there are some conjectures in mathematics that are still unsolved. So in that sense we can say that the none of this. Please remember in this case also that the conjectures which is still unsolved, it is a point of time, means it is a point of time when the conjectures are unsolved, but there may be in a future a point of time when it will get a solution, and there are lot of a case. Goldberg conjecture is one of the very good example which is still unsolved, and there are lot of conjecture that are still unsolved, but it doesn't mean that mathematical problem will not have a solution. It will have a solution. It is the only point of a time, it is a matter of a point of a time where the problem is unsolved. It doesn't mean that it will be unsolved for years. Even it is unsolved for 100 years, but sometime it will get a solution. So in that sense mathematics is an exact science. It will have a unique solution, but in the case it may not be the same. Suppose that when we find the boiling temperature of a water, we used to say that it is 100 degree, but boil the water in your home, the tap water I am talking about, tap water, and measure the temperature, you won't get the 100 degree, because it is dependent on certain premises. The premises are the atmospheric pressure and the purity of a water. If you will change that atmospheric pressure, then the boiling temperature of a water will change. If you will change the purity of a water, the boiling temperature of a water will change, and that's why on that principle pressure cooker works. We increase the temperature, and that's why the boiling temperature is increased, and the food inside the pressure cooker is getting a more energy, and it is cooked at a fast rate. That's the reason. Another thing, when we talk like that, we frame a statement. Today is a Monday. Okay. Today is a Monday. Is it this statement is right or wrong? Can anybody reply me? Is the statement is a right or wrong?
Right, sir.
It is a right, but with a premises. The premises is that it is right, correct, from the today's midnight, means 12 o'clock midnight, to today night 59 minute 59 second p.m. After that it won't be valid. When you will say the same statement tomorrow, it will be not a valid, it will be wrong. But in mathematics, when I say 3 plus 5, it is always correct. So in that sense mathematical statements are always accurate and correct. Or wrong, either it will be right or wrong. Suppose that I frame a mathematical statement 3 plus 3 equal to 5, it will be wrong, and all the time wrong. So in that sense when we see the mathematical statement, it is ambiguity free, it won't be ambiguous sentence. But in the language when we frame the sentence, it is not either right or wrong, it may have ambiguity. Like that one statement I framed, today is a Monday, it ambiguous sentence, because it won't be valid all the time. Valid means either it should be right or it should be wrong, so it won't be valid all the time. it will be valid on certain premises. If the premises will be fulfilled, then it will be valid, otherwise it won't be valid. So mathematical statement is always either right or wrong, but there will be no ambiguity like that the one sentence I have exemplified here. And in that sense it is said that mathematics is a precision is a beauty of mathematics. Mathematical statements are precise and accurate. Precise and accurate means either it will be right or wrong, but not it will have an ambiguity, but it is possible that the statement from the other discipline may contain the ambiguity. May contain. I am not saying that always it will be ambiguous sentence. No, how it will be, but it may contain. A valid statement may contain ambiguity in other discipline, but in mathematical valid sentence will never be ambiguous sentence. And that's why when we define a mathematical statement, the two characteristics we use to include, the one thing that it must be declarative sentence. Mathematical sentence is always a declarative sentence. It won't be exclamatory sentence, or it won't be interrogative sentence, hai na? But it will be declarative only, and it must be ambiguity free. It won't be ambiguous. So that's the definition of mathematical statement. It won't have any ambiguity. The next thing we can talk about the nature of mathematics, that mathematics is a science of number. It is said that it is the science of number. Means whenever we are talking about mathematics, numeracy, numbers will come. And in the previous class I was discussing that mathematics has emerged as a felt need of the counting. Numeracy was the core of development of mathematics in the earlier days. Nowadays a lot of branch of mathematics has emerged, developed as a felt need, where only numeracy is not a major part. Because mathematics itself is not a subject which deals numbers. It deals other things also, but the core of mathematics is a number. Like that, mathematics deals with the logic also. Mathematics is a logical. Mathematics is a science of number. We have to convert anything in a numerical form in order to solve a mathematical problem. Side by side, mathematics is a logical in nature also, because when we proceed, when we think of solving any mathematical problem, when we think of arriving a solution, we have to come with the logic. Suppose that you are solving a problem. So when you will proceed from the one step to another step, you will consider that what are the premises is given, what are the things you have been provided in order to solve the problem, and what are the conditions are given, means in which condition you have to solve the problem. And the third thing will be that what you are required to get, what kind of a solution you are looking for. Okay, so when in this situation, when we proceed, when we think of solving, you must frame a logical procedures. So this is the given, this is the premises, this is the condition, and that kind of a solution we are looking for. So in this type of a thing, what could be the expected steps, what could be the expected things, the sequence that we have to think in order to solve the problem, and with this logic we proceed from one step to another step. Likewise, the other discipline, the mathematics discipline, is more logical in nature, because without the logic you cannot proceed in mathematics. And in fact, whatever the other sciences we see, that is the physical science or the biological science or even the chemical science or even in the science, social science and humanities, when we see the mathematics as a discipline, it is more logical. We cannot proceed from one step to another step without having a proper logic for that step. If we are not considering, if we are able to visualize the logic, we cannot proceed. So in that way, the mathematics is more logical in nature. It is precise, it is accurate, it is exact, and it is logical in nature as well. The another thing we can talk about, that mathematics is a subject of a reasoning, where the mathematical concept has been developed with the reasoning procedures. And when we talk about that, the reasoning procedure, we know that there are two types of reasoning in mathematics. One is the inductive reasoning, another one is the deductive reasoning. So these two type of reasoning interplays a role in mathematics. When we talk about the inductive reasoning, it is a kind of a reasoning which proceeds from the particular to general. Okay, particular to general, particular case to the formula, example to formula, concrete to abstract. How? Suppose that we are interested to calculate the sum of natural numbers. Suppose that it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, up to 20. We want to calculate, we are interested to calculate the sum of number 1 to 20. One of the procedure may be that we have to add each individual number and we have to arrive the solution. But remember, it is a very much time taking. So what we used to do, that when we see the summation of a number from 1 to 2, that is 1 and 2, it is 3. When we proceed 1, 2, 3, that is the summation of 1 plus 2 plus 3, it comes 6. When we see the summation of a number 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4, it comes 10. And up to 5, it comes 15. Up to 6, it comes 21. And when we see the patterns, we find that the result of summation is nothing but in a pattern of n into n plus 1 by 2, means you have to multiply the number up to where you are interested to get the solution with one more. Means if I am interested to sum the number up to 10, then 10 into 10 plus 1, 11, and we have to divide it by 2, so it will come the 55. So it is a very easy to calculate the summation of any number. So how it came? With observing the sequence, with observing the pattern, in what pattern the summation of a number is linked. And when we are able to identify the pattern, that generalized pattern we can use as a formula. So we have seen each individual case, particular case, in order to derive a formula, and that kind of a reasoning is known as a inductive reasoning in mathematics. Induction is possible in mathematics. We can observe a sufficient number of observation cases, and on the basis of a sufficient number of observation, we can come to a generalization. We can generalize the formula, and the generalization means that we can use those formula in future for the calculations. But remember, whenever we talk about the generalization, there is a one precaution. The generalization must be done on the sufficient number of observations. Sufficient number of observation means that the large number of observation, by observing two or three cases, you cannot guarantee that whatever you have generalized is correct, is appropriate. Like that, one more example you take. Suppose that I am a framing on the basis I am observing number 1. Okay, it is a prime number. Number 3, it is a prime number and odd number. Odd and prime. 5, odd and prime. 7, odd and prime. 11, odd and prime. 13, odd and prime. 17, odd and prime. And now I have concluded, I have observed a cases, so many cases, 5, 4, 5, 6 cases, and I have come to a conclusion, so all odd number will be prime number. See, what is the danger? All odd number is not a prime number. We have a 9, odd number but not a prime number. We have a 15, odd number but not a prime number. 21, odd but not prime. So if you will not have a sufficient number of observation to conclude, then it will be dangerous. Dangerous means the conclusion will not be appropriate. You will lead to a wrong conclusion. And that's why the another thing in the induction also come, that when we induce a formula based upon the observation, that is the induction, and we have a sufficient number of observation, it will be true, but at the some time, at a some moment, it can be falsified also. For sake of example, when we observe, suppose that we have observed and induced a formula n into n plus 1 by 2 for summation of n natural number, but we must have observed a certain number of cases, because we know that the numbers are unlimited, there is no limit of number, there is infinite numbers. When I say 1 lakh, means 1 plus 1, 1 lakh 1 is also possible. When we say even the 1 crore, the another bigger number than 1 crore is possible. So numbers are unlimited, infinite. So observing the case will be also infinite. But certainly we have not observed infinite number of cases. We must have observed a long number of cases, big number of cases, but it is a limited. So it may be possible at certain moment this generalized formula may falsify. Like that, when we see the formula to calculate the all interior angle of a polygon, it has been generalized by the observation. Okay, so like that, the kind of inductive reasoning process work in mathematics, inductive reasoning. And that's why we have another method of teaching mathematics, that is known as the inductive method of teaching mathematics, where we illustrate an individual case and we come to a generalization. But when we induce a formula in mathematics, obviously when the formula will be induced, that formula is going to used, and that reasoning is known as a deductive reasoning. That is known as a deductive reasoning, and that is why deductive reasoning works from general to particular, formula to particular case example. Because whatever the formula we have induced in the inductive reasoning, that we are going to suppose that we have induced a formula n into n plus 1 by 2, that is for the summation of n natural number, then whenever we are required to sum, we will not sum the individual number, rather than we will use the formula and we will get the summation. So that is known as the deductive reasoning. One more thing here is important to require, that in the most of the reference material like a textbook, some of the textbook, even the internet, you will find that induction is a opposite to deduction, and a deduction is a opposite to induction. Please remember, it is not like that. Induction is a neighbor opposite to deduction. Side by side, the deduction is a neighbor opposite to induction. Both are complement to each other, both go hand to hand each other. Because whenever we are inducing a formula, we are going to use, means the deduction is inbuilt. Whenever we are using the formula in the deductive process, it has come through the induction. So it is not a case of opposite to each other, but in fact both of them fulfills each other, both fulfills each other, not opposite. And in mathematics we have an inductive method of teaching mathematics as well as the deductive method of teaching mathematics. Both the things we have, induction also we have, deduction also we have. So that's the beauty of mathematics, and that is the one of the important nature of mathematics. As here I was discussing that mathematics have a inductive reasoning as well as the mathematics have a deductive reasoning also. And the induction, we are inducing a formula with observing the pattern, and that's why we used to say that mathematics is the study of patterns, is a science of pattern. Because in the mathematics we used to study the patterns, and on the basis of studying the pattern we generalize and we come to a mathematical theory. Okay, so mathematical theory, the basic mathematical theory has been derived by observing the pattern. Let it be from the geometry, let it be from the arithmetic, let it be from the even the trigonometry or the other science. It has been derived with the study of pattern. And mathematics in that sense seems to be more close to the nature, because nature itself is a big source of different kind of patterns. Let you see the patterns in the leaf, let you see patterns in the tides coming in the sea, let you see the patterns in the some of the picture framed in the desert. Mathematics is a science of a pattern, and it seems to be more close to the nature. Even yesterday I was watching one of the movie, that is a recent movie, you must have heard of that, it is a Shakuntala Devi. In that she says that the even the leaf in which it is organized, it is a pattern in nature, so that the each leaf can get a maximum sun rays light, because that is very much important for the photosynthesis. And as much as the light they will get, it will maximize the process of photosynthesis. Other constituent part of the photosynthesis is also there, but the one of the major part is the sunlight. So in that sense it seems to be more closer to the nature also. Now I will stop the class, and I will mention one and two things also. Mathematics, it's also said to be the father of science. It is said that it is the queen of all sciences, because the development of science, especially the modern science, will never be possible without the development of mathematics. You can think of the biology, you can think of a chemical science, you can think of physical science, you can think of even the social science and humanities, history, geography. The development will not be as that much at this level without the development of mathematics. And in the previous class also I was mentioning that when the Newton was studying the astronomy, he felt that it is a very difficult to calculate the things with the existing set of mathematics available, and he has developed a branch of mathematics which in turn assisted him to a study. So nowadays it is even nowadays we have a blend of mathematics with the other sciences, interdisciplinary, like that you can study the biotechnology, you cannot study without the mathematics, computer science, you cannot study without the mathematics. So in that sense mathematics is said to be the father of science, it is a queen of all sciences. Okay, so this was all about for the discussion under the mathematics, and that's why it is said that in order to teach mathematics you must be very fluent in the nature of mathematics, and it is true for all discipline. Whatever the things you are going to teach, you must know the nature of that, then only effectively you will be able to teach, otherwise not. Okay, so that was all about, and now the session is open for the question. You are required to ask any kind of question or queries, whatever you have. I think that one message I have got, for x plus 2 is greater than 4, here x belongs to 3 and infinite, how it is the exact? Okay, so I told that mathematics is the exact science and it will have a exactness. Okay, so he is asking that x plus 2, which is greater than 4, it is the one mathematical statement he is asking, Motendu, that x plus 2 is greater than 4, and the solution is that x can take any value which is greater and equal to 3. So how in this sense how it is exact? It is exact because it takes a different a particular set of a number for which this statement is true. Suppose that I take a negative number, I took minus 2, the statement won't be true. I took minus 10, the statement won't be true. I took 0, I took minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, it won't be true. The exactness which here I am referring is a set of number. like that I was talking about the quadratic equation. Quadratic equation also have a two solution, may have a two solution, it may have a unique solution also, it may have a two numbers as a solution, but the set is unique. Here which you are talking about, the set is the positive numbers equal and greater than 3, either it will be equal or greater, but in fact it is not only 3, you can take 2.1, the statement will also be true. 2.3, the statement also be true. So it is a true for the positive number greater than, where the x can take a value greater than 2, not 3. It will be greater than 2. 2.1 plus 2, it is greater than 4. ठीक है, यदि आप उसमें आप लिख देंगे कि रियल नंबर है ऐसे है तो देन द केस विल बी डिफरेंट, बट द यूनिकनेस द एग्जैक्टनेस इज अ सेट ऑफ नंबर एंड वेन वी विल सॉल्व दिस स्टेटमेंट वी विल से दैट द नंबर ग्रेटर देन टू, एक्स कैन टेक वैल्यू ग्रेटर देन टू, हमको 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 लिखने की जरूरत नहीं है, दैट इज द प्रिसिजन, ये प्रिसाइज है ना, मैथमेटिक्स इज अ प्रिसाइज साइंस. ओके, इज इट ओके टू यू मोतेंदु? योर वॉइस इज नॉट ऑडेबल. हाँ मोतेंदु, योर वॉइस इज नॉट ऑडेबल, रियली नथिंग आई एम एबल टू लिसन.
In
this sense, I am talking. Motendu, can you message me once again? Whatever you are saying, you please message me. And meanwhile, I will be taking the queries from other. And when I will get your question in the written, I will reply also. Okay. So anybody? I should not.
Sir, sir.
Ha. Asutosh.
Sir, we are saying that मुझे लगता है कि
कैसे कैसे आपको लगता है बताइए.
हम जो प्रॉब्लम सॉल्व करता है विदाउट मैथमेटिक्स कैन नॉट साइंस
not getting Asutosh really when okay, so Asutosh, you just also write, I got the query from the Motendu, you write in the chat box Asutosh, so I will be replying Motendu and meanwhile you type in the chat box. Monday text from time from 12 a.m. to okay, then this can be exact. See, the kind of query you are arising, Motendu, you are saying that Monday takes from time from 12 a.m. to 11:59 p.m. then this can be also exact. Okay, this is the exact, means at particular time I am making a statement that today is a Monday, but this example I have given to show another thing, that is the ambiguity in the mathematical statement. Mathematical statement can't be ambiguous, but other sentence, mean the sentence from the other discipline may have the ambiguity, like that the statement I was talking, that the statement today is a Monday is the ambiguous statement, because after some moment it won't be valid, after some time it won't be valid. Okay, So in that sense, it is the ambiguous statement. But when you are talking about the exactness of this statement, it is not exact because the statement is not valid all the time. It is valid only at a particular moment of a time. It is not valid all the time. So here the point of exactness will not come, because when you are saying that 12 a.m. to 11:59 p.m. So every 12 a.m. to 11:59 p.m. is not a Monday. It is the particular moment which comes once in a week, that is the term as a Monday. It is not always correct. Okay, so it is a true at a particular moment of a time. It is not exact. But when we talk about the mathematical statement, whatever the solution we will have, it will be true in all the cases, all the time. Like that, the one statement you have posed, x plus 2 equal greater than 4. So the solution will be the x will carry the value greater than 2. It is true all the time. Okay, so in that sense, it is not exact. Okay, if you have another query, you can post in the message. Meanwhile, I will take from the Asutos. We can't solve the problem of a science without the math. So I think math is not abstract. See, helping other discipline is a different thing, and especially the concept from a mathematics is a different thing. And here when we talk about the abstractness, it is based upon, when you in order to understand it in a better manner, you just go through the what is the definition of abstractness. Abstractness is a phenomena which shows that you won't be able to visualize, you won't be able to see, you won't be able to observe, you won't be able to demonstrate. That phenomena is known as the abstractness. And in that sense, mathematical concept, it is a very difficult and it is impossible to demonstrate, to show, illustrate and observe. So in that sense, it is abstract, but it helps the science. Okay, and that's why it is not abstract, or science is also abstract, is not a valid logical argument. Because helping, suppose that you are from the university department of teacher education, Utkal University. You are a student of Utkal University. Okay, but and you are helping some other student from the other university. So in that logic, I cannot say that you also belong to that university. You are just helping, but you belong to Utkal University as a student. You are belonging from the Utkal University. You are not belonging to other university. You may help the student of other university, but it doesn't mean that you belong from the other university. This is not a valid logical argument. Okay, that is the case, Asutos. Is this clear? Anybody? Anybody else? Okay, so I think there is no question now. So we will conclude this discussion on the nature of mathematics here only. Thank you for being with me. Have a nice day.